What up, everybody? This is Fitz.
And Noel.
From Fitz and the Tantrums, and you are watching...
Ambi.
That's right, Ambi.
Hey everyone, it's Alicia from Ambi, and I would like to welcome you to our interview with Fitz and the Tantrums.
Hey, thank you.
Hello, how are you both doing today?
Great.
You're now on the Get Right Back tour. Just let our viewers know, how is this whole thing treating you so far?
I mean, it's been amazing. This, you know, our album just came out like a week and a half, 2 weeks ago, and we're on the first tour, the Get Right Back tour, that's going to be going all summer long. And it's been really incredible, I think, for us to finally get our songs out there, play them live for people, and just to see the reaction. It's been pretty incredible.
Yeah, pretty amazing. We played in New York, in Rochester, last night, and it was unbelievable. Just like an amazing crowd. You know, it's actually really fun because we are visiting cities that we've never been to before, just like in these smaller kind of communities, and just the reaction there has been insane. So we really get to see how far our music has spread just even in the last like couple months. Yeah.
Well, I think a lot of people don't really realize all the stuff that goes on behind the scenes when you're on tour. It's not just the show.
It's not glamorous all the time, no.
But you've been posting a lot of photographs of tour meals that you're having together as a band. So what's been the best meal you've had on the tour so far?
Oh, you know, we... New York is always really amazing. There's a restaurant called The Dutch that a friend of mine owns. Andrew Carmelini is like a Michelin star chef, James Beard award winning kind of thing. So everything that, you know, I had this amazing like black cod and he had the fried chicken and, you know, that's always like really cool to get treated. But for the most part, we've been staying pretty healthy, you know, just trying to like make sure that we're not exhausted, yes. You know, with fatty foods all the time.
It's hard
and
to perform on a
out.
Full belly.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it is. Absolutely.
You got to watch it. Got to keep that figure.
Exactly. Got to work hard in this band.
Hey, yeah.
And what would you say has been the coolest thing to happen since this new self-titled record was released?
I mean, you know, for us, I think, you know, the new single's called Hand Clap, and just that song has been doing so well. You know, we're already playing it, and the reaction is just so massive to that song, and to see it, like, getting played so much on the radio, and I just think we're just feel so excited about that.
Yeah, I mean, you know, for the most part, we've been a very lucky band when it's come to our music. You know, there's been a lot of word-of-mouth stuff, and you know, we've worked really hard for this. We're almost, you know, it's like almost 8 years now since we've been a band. And,
yep.
You know, it's like we've hit the ground running for a really long time. And, you know, we worked really hard in our first couple of years together. We never said no to anything. And that, I think, just took us further and further. You know, we have so much support with radio. And, you know, people are genuinely interested in making sure that we, you know, incline and,
yeah.
And just keep going further. So it's a lot of fun.
I'm very happy that Fitz, you brought up Hand Clap. It's not just a great song, but the video you posted for it is amazing. Like some dance routines went on in that.
Oh, well, that's a dream come true. Noel and I have always wanted to do kind of a legit hip-hop dance video, and so for us to get to do this, those dancers were amazing.
What was it like filming that? Kind of take us behind the scenes. Did it take you a long time to get that all done?
Well, you know, the entire set was built. You know, the director, first of all, is incredible. His, you know, resume, you know, Country Grammar by Nelly was like one of my favorite songs. And he directed that video, much like Destiny's Child. So he has this really long resume of artists that he's worked with, including Justin Timberlake. So it was actually to have that scale of a director, you know, for... We've worked with some incredible directors, but that was like, okay, we're,
next
you
level.
Know, that was a next level kind of thing. But they built the entire set. Everyone was super sweet. Everyone was professional. Everybody had fun on that set that day, you know, so it was actually.
And we got our workout.
We got our workout on. Yeah. Rehearsals, like dance rehearsals. Like it was pretty cool.
Did you pick up on it pretty easily?
Yeah, well, Fitz was in it. It was cool.
We both have a little bit of dancing skills. I mean, we're not professional dancers, but we can do an eight count.
I can get down.
What are some of your favorite dance moves? I couldn't see that video and not ask.
I don't know. You know, like I grew up in the era of like the old hip hop stuff. So it's, you know, it's like all the Running Mans and, you know.
Oh, my bit. I love the Running like Man. Old.
You know, and it's like at some, you know, some point, I think everybody just starts doing the same dance. You know, it's like you're out with your friends and stuff and everybody's doing the same moves. And
hey.
Unless you're watching other people's videos, it's, you know, it's all either down or up from there.
I love how on this tour you're letting fans come up to the merch tables and they can get their hands painted neon just like the album cover. Tell me a bit about that cover. What's the significance behind the neon having the hand on there?
I think, well, you know, we've always tried to incorporate some sort of neon theme, and that when people see our set design, which is a whole new design that we developed for this tour, which is amazing. But for the hand, you know, it was really, I love the image of that hand because it means so many different things. You know, it can be like a gesture of stop or raise your hand to be heard or seen. You know, and so for us to have that, and obviously the song is called Hand Clap, so it just all worked together.
Yeah, definitely for me, you know, we've always worked in progressively building our music, you know, further to, you know, step out of the box. And I think, you know, even having a self-titled album, we really put the imprint on our music. You know, this is who we are. This is our sound. We've earned every single moment that we've had in our lives. We've worked really hard. And, you know, for me, the significance of putting your handprint on something, it can never be taken away because your handprint is your own, you know. So I really like that factor and the fact that we've tied in, you know, everything that we've done in our careers. Yeah. You know, it's like men and women and, you know, just this like community kind of, you know, sound. You know, we have fans that are children to, you know, grandparents, you know, listening to our stuff. So it's fun. So definitely that hand represents that for me.
Totally.
This is my first time seeing you tonight, so I'm very excited about that.
Oh, get ready to get your dance
pull
on,
your
girl.
Hair back. Definitely.
Wear comfortable
very
shoes.
Excited. Comfortable shoes. I think I got that covered. We're good.
Black helps as well. Black hides a lot of sweat, so you have that too.
I'm glad I came prepared. That's
yes,
good.
Yes, exactly.
But do you get fans at any point in the set to kind of put their hands up and you see that big wave of just neon hands in the air?
Oh, well, you'll see. We don't accept people being wallflowers at our show. Our show is all about how we interact with the audience, and the more we give to them and get them to give back to us, and it becomes this infinity loop of energy. But we don't let our audience sit still. The whole thing's like a very interactive experience.
Yeah, it's really hard to, you know, Snapchat and tweet and do all of that kind of thing. So you have to be very present when you're at our shows, you know, and just have a really good time.
And when you're seeing the people react in such an energetic and excited way towards your music when you're performing, what's running through your mind when you're on stage?
I mean, that actually feeds us.
Yeah.
You know, it's a very help. I mean, you know, it's like you start getting into the middle of the tour and all you want to do is just nap. You know, it's just like
it's true.
2 hours before the set, you're like crawling out of your bunk and you're doing warm ups. And, you know, my hair gets kind of crazy. So I have to, you know, get prepared for all of that. But, you know, stepping on stage is very inspirational for us because if the crowd's not into it, we're not doing our jobs.
Yeah.
You know, it's like we don't want people to pay money to see us and they're bored, you know. So we feed off of the energy, not just with, you know, our entire unit, but also with the crowd, the big, you know, seventh member of that show.
I came across a really great quote that I loved from you, Fitz, and you're pretty much saying, I think we're in one of the greatest eras in music right now. So many barriers have been lifted and everybody is doing really special, exciting things in music. Who do you feel are some artists that our viewers should check out that are doing something special?
Jack Garrett, for sure.
We interviewed him right here.
Awesome. Yeah.
A guy named John Bellion, who he's been around for a while, but like I've really just gotten into his new album. It's incredible. He does everything. You know, it's got this really kind of hip hop thing going on, but like very interesting music happening before the verses. Kind of reminds me a little bit of 21 Pilots. Okay. And, you know, it's just like a really, really cool artist. Fantagram, I'm fans of. I'm also friends with those guys and they're just incredible people. So this new record, I'm actually looking forward to.
How about yourself?
What else? I mean, I'm a huge fan of that 21 Pilots record. Ricky Reed, who did produce most of that record, also did Hand Clap for us. But I just think that record is so original and inspired. And it's not always that I hear somebody else's album and get a little jealous. But, you know, I love that record.
So the Blurry Face record?
Yeah.
It's a good one.
Strong record.
Well, just to wrap things up today, is there anything you want to say to all of the Fits and the Tantrums fans who will be viewing the interview?
Thank you so much for the support.
Go get the new record.
Get the new album if you don't have it. Stream it, share it with all of your friends who don't know who we are, and you know, come see the shows when we're in your town.
Totally.
Fantastic. And just thank you so much for doing this. We really appreciate
it. Oh, please. Our
pleasure. Thank you.
It's my pleasure. And remember, to everybody viewing, you can visit us at imusicblogia.com for all kinds of interviews, features, videos, and so much more with your favorite bands. We'll see you next time.